Good morning, everyone, or should I say good afternoon. I just wanted to recap from last week, asking about, telling us basically what does your body currently tell you and what do you want it to say to you. Hopefully you guys have continued to bring those responses in. I'm loving it. Hopefully I've given a better response back to you, words of encouragement, things and tools that you may need to do. Today, I want to talk about what do you have to stop doing to achieve your fitness goal? What is it that you have to currently do right now? What is sabotaging your success? Okay. Is it just getting somewhere and just moving? Are you able to, just get up and walk outside at least 2 to 3 times out the week? Are you, working out and not eating after you get done working out? You're wondering like, oh, I don't want to, gain weight because I just worked out, so I'm not going to eat. And you know that's the reversal role of what your body needs. The body needs to replenish after what you've just done to it in the gym. Have you joined a gym or had a personal trainer or joined a boot camp, something to get your body revved up? One of the things that we want to talk about now is just behaviors. You got to, get the mindset of, okay, I'm going to do something active today. If we use our Apple Watches or Fitbits to kind of guide us there, but to achieve your fitness goal, one of the things you have to stop doing is, I would say, not set unrealistic goals. I know we talked about that before. Take things as they are. Just get to a point where you're saying, hey, I'm going to walk, 2 times this week, and then you increase from there. Or I'm going to go join a gym today, and I'm going to go 3 times a week. Or I'm going to get a friend, and we're going to go, and you're going to be my accountability partner. But you don't want to set goals for yourself, and then they're unattainable, and then you get bad, and then you're not able to get to your fitness goal. So I'm trying to make sure that you're not going on an emotional roller coaster. It's very, very important that that you don't do that to yourself, because you'll never succeed. So make sure that you're taking things piece by piece. And I know I've gone over time, but this is one of the things that we discuss in our gym constantly, is when people come to us and they want to start off, whether that's 21 days or they're ready to jump right in and join our gym, is let's talk about your goals. And are they measurable and attainable? And if they are one of those things, then we move forward. If they're not, then we talk about the why and to go deeper. So sorry I went over a little bit more time today, but just wanted to point these things out. But let me know. Let me know what's stopping you from your fitness goal so we can talk more about it. And then what behaviors have you been doing to sabotage to keep you from that success? So hopefully this message has been good. I know it went over on my time. Maybe it makes up for the time I had 3 weeks ago when I went maybe like a minute. So you guys take care, and I'll be looking forward to you guys next week. Take care.